Miss Bakai, sorry for being a little bit behind today, but I just got off the road and the father showed some driving diligence for my Isha. We made it back from my trip and wanted to make sure we got back for Shabbat and also for our listeners out there on live stream. For those that would call in, that would view. So, want to, we're going to have a few things we're going to run across today or go over today. Not in-depth studies, but just some things for you to think about and looking for your suggestions. So, as we get started, we're going to have Kiki to give us our website addresses.
www.living-branch.org, www.healingfoundation.org.
Thank you, Kiki. Now we have Bina to give us our email address. And why would someone send to this email address?
Prayer and prophecy.
Right. So what is our email address that they can send?
prayer@living-branch.org.
All right, Toda. So, tonight is our prayer and prophecy. What we're going to do is just briefly talk about, well, let's pray first. Baruch Hashem Yahuwah Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Father, thank you for another Shabbat. Thank you, Father, for all of your goodness. Thank you, Father, for being wiser and smarter than we are, because sometimes we think we know and we think we got it all figured out. But Father, hands down, you know the beginning from the end. You know, Father, what needs to transpire and what needs to happen. Thank you for being the one that orchestrates our life. And Father, we ask your forgiveness when we've complained about paths you've taken us down, when you knew why you took us down a path. Thank you, Father, and we just ask you, Father, to continue to show us mercy, show us favor, do the things necessary in our lives, Father, to help us to become better, to help us to be told, to help us to be tomio, very good at what we're doing in this walk. Thank you, Father, in the name of Mashiach Yahusha, Hallel to Yahuwah. Amen. Now, Ms. Bakai, there's a lot of lessons and a lot of things out there to study on. We'll soon be coming out with some stuff on the calendar to try to get everybody on the same page. But let me just remind you of something. That's why if you start looking into the Hebrew, these feast days are called rehearsals. Now, at a rehearsal, you're practicing for the main performance. So when the Mashiach comes and the main performance is executed out for these last fall feast days, it's going to be perfect because he's going to orchestrate it. So, you know, that's why you're going to have some that follow the moon, some follow the sun. You're going to have so many people doing different things. But we're all, I believe, trying to get to the same place, and that's to perfect our rehearsal. Now, one thing about it, let's say you a day off on your rehearsal date. It's practice. You keep practicing so you can perfect it. But there are some things you need to work on every day. The weightier matters of the Torah that is spoken about, that the Mashiach spoke about. And we often forget those. We often, mercy, justice, faith, we forget those. Oh, mercy, judgment, faith, we forget those. We forget that there are weightier matters. Loving your neighbor. New commandment he's giving you, to love your neighbor as he's loved you. So, we can't forget those things, because keeping the commandments how we engage the Father and how we engage others are going to play a major role. And when you start reading back in the Dead Sea Scrolls, you'll find they had a couple of different calendars operating. But what I want to make sure that you have operating are some of these major things, because we don't want to be like the scribes and the Pharisees, that we focus so much on the ceremonial stuff that we forget what this is really all about. You know, he talked about, and when you start reading in Matthew or Matthew, the fifth chapter, and he started talking about adultery and murder and different things like that. How are you treating other people? You know, how are you treating them? You want to be in the kingdom, then you have to treat the king's children accordingly. So I just want to remind you of that so that you don't lose sight. And I'm not telling you don't study, don't seek out things, because I'm studying, seeking things out. I'm much further along than I used to be when I first started. Have I perfected everything? Have I perfected the calendar? Have I perfected all the feast days? No. Am I rehearsing? Yes, I'm rehearsing to perfect and get it like the Father wants it. But my day-to-day living, how I handle my tongue, how I treat my neighbors, how I treat my wife, how the wife treats her husband, how you treat your children, how your children treat you, all those things are grounded. Am I passing this on to my children? Am I telling them about us being slaves in Egypt or Mitzrayim? What am I doing in those areas? You know, don't get, you know, the Father's going to show us. We're going to get this calendar. We're going to get other things pertaining to the Moedim down. I mean, he's giving us ground. He's showing us the name. He shows the Mashiach's name. He's going to help us perfect that. So, you know, continue to study, continue to seek his face. But those basic principles of love, because remember in 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, you can do all this stuff. And maybe we should just go there for us, just 1 second. I'm not going to belabor it. But I definitely want you to see it. Chapter of 1 Corinthians. And we're looking at the first verse. And I bring this to you because I wouldn't be a shepherd or a leader if I didn't try to make sure to keep everyone focused. Because, you know, we can go all over the place. And I'm studying, I'm seeking the Father on different teachings and things. Some teachings I haven't even presented yet because it's not time. I asked my Isha if she would read the first through the third verse.
If I speak with the tongues of men and of messengers, but do not have love, I have become as sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophecy and know all secrets and all knowledge, and if I have all belief so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am none at all. And if I give out all my possessions to feed the poor, and if I give my body to be burned, but do not have love, I am not profited at all.
Okay, let's read the fourth through the sixth verse, and then I'll just talk a little bit.
Love is patient, is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not boast. Is not puffed up. Does not behave indecently. does not seek its own, is not provoked, reckons not the evil, does not rejoice over the unrighteousness, but rejoices in the truth. It covers all, believes all, expects all, endures all.
This is the same love that the Mashiach was talking about in St. John, or Yehuchanan, the 14th chapter and 15th verse, when he said, if you love me, keep my commandments. Same Ahab love. Same love. So you can do all these things. You can gain all knowledge. You can give your body to be burned. You can give all your goods to the poor. But if the underlying reason of what you're doing or what's motivating you is not love, when I'm talking about the love from the Father, then it's not going to profit you anything. So we're seeking these things and we're trying to get understanding and learning and studying because we love him and we want to make sure we're keeping his commandments properly. But in the same venue, we want to make sure that we are exhibiting his love to others like we should, because that's a big part of it all. So what I want you to do, Ms. Bakar, for me, email me your suggestions that you might have for future lessons. Maybe there's a subject that you want us to teach on. I'll consider all subjects. And then whatever the Ruach HaKodesh leads me, the set apart spirit leads me to teach on, those will be the ones that I teach on. So you can send those and make sure you put in the subject line future lessons, so I'll know that email is specifically for that. And you can email them to info@living-branch.org. And I want to just say to those that have been donating and have been giving to the ministry and helping us to do the bookmarkers and function as a ministry, those that have been out of generosity of their hearts, I want to say, Toda, I want to say thank you. I'm humbled, and I pray that the Father richly blesses you for what you're doing, because truly, when you give, you give out of a pure heart, the Father will return it unto you. So, Toda, for that love that you're showing in your giving. And we really appreciate it, because we're coming up on time where we're going to renew our subscription with Livestream. And of course, you know, though, you don't go to them and say, hey, I'm going to pay for this on a fast and a prayer. It don't work like that. Those folks want money. And bookmarker people, they want money. So thank you to all those that have committed and that have sent in donations and gifts. And I pray the Father blesses you for that. Now, we had a new project that just rolled out. One of the good things that's going to help you in your walk is going to be your Hebrew. Learning your Hebrew. It all starts with your Hebrew Olivet. Your Hebrew Olivet. And I'm going to give you an example here. We'll go back over. We'll go to Genesis, first chapter, 16th verse. And I'll just make this a little bit bigger here. Now, when I was studying this right here, we know this right here is not in the text because it's italicized. But this right here, this also threw me for a loop. Because you don't see, per se, see it in the text, but when you start to look in the text, I'll show you where it is. Okay, if you're looking right here, It doesn't say it, but this right here, this vav is an and. Then you have aleph tav in the text. So whenever you're going here and you see, there's the word for stars. Okay, and see you have vayet. Vayet. And then it's haku kabi kabim. That's stars. And that's saying and stars. Or you could translate it stars also. So, you know, just your journey in learning your Hebrew is going to be very important. And what I try to do, I try to put out things that will be useful and helpful. So what I want, let me see if I can find it here. Just give me 1 second, Miss Baka. Just got to switch around a little bit. Right here is the first Hebrew primer practice journal. It's the adult beginners practice journal for biblical Hebrew. Now, when it says biblical Hebrew, this is for modern day Hebrew, for the modern Hebrew. We would do the paleo in another edition. So if you're learning Hebrew, you need to practice writing your Olivet. Would you like to have one central location to practice in? What happens? This practice journal is a simple solution. It will show you how to form your letters and give you a practice area to go over each letter. And this is how it looks. I didn't put the inside cover. And you'll see that this journal, there might be some out there, but this journal has 100 pages for you to practice your 22 Olivets and also your 5 final forms, which the final forms are the letters that appear at the end of a word. And you'll be able to practice, and it'll give you instructions and show you how to form each letter. Now, it's available on Amazon. Don't go there tonight during Shabbat, but it is available on Amazon. And I think this will be beneficial in your journey to learning your Hebrew Olivet. And there's also a song out there that just like we learned our Olivets by singing, or our alphabet by singing A, B, C, D, E, F, G. That's how we learned it. We put it to a song. Well, there's a song out there with the Hebrew Olivet. Olivet, Gimel, Dalet, Hey. Keep on singing it, Bina.
Ba, Zion, Het, Tet, Yud. Kaf, Lam, Mim, Nim, Zom, and Ayin, Pei. Zadi, Kof, Ration, Sin, Tav. Now I know my Olivet. Singing it, I won't forget.
See? So that's the Hebrew Olivet. Now, how did they learn it? Both of my children learned it by listening to that song. I learned it by, I put it on a CD and I played it over and over and over till I was singing it in my sleep. Then when I started writing, because remember in when you were in school, you learned to say it. Then you wrote it. So if you want information on where to get that song from, email me at info@living-branch.org and I'll send it and I'll show you where you can get it from. And get this practice journal, which I'm going to also give you a place you can go to that'll take you through the Hebrew Olivet, the lessons, where you can practice not only writing them, but saying them also. So now you can get this copy. You don't get it today. It's Shabbat. You can go to HebrewFoundation.org/books or here's the create space where you can go and get the first Hebrew primer practice journal. Okay, now let's jump back over here, Ms. Baka. Now, if you haven't already, make sure you join our bookmark witnessing team. It is going fantastic. People are passing out these bookmarks, and we've had a lot of hits on our website, which is yahuwah.co. So if you want to sign up, go to www.bm.hebrewfoundation.org. And this is the bookmarker website. It has a video on it that will walk the person through the bookmarker. Now, I remember I was talking about the Hebrew lessons. If you go to living-branch.org and click on e-learning, there's a Hebrew course there that gives 4 lessons that you can sign up for free. And it will walk you through and help you tell you which Olivets to practice. Now, in the future, we will offer lessons once things are a little more settled during the week. We'll start offering lessons for those that want to learn Hebrew. And myself, I'm learning and perfecting mine. So, you know, once that's done, I'll be able to help others. So I'm just trying to come up with tools that'll help you in your journey. Alrighty, so if you want to support, of course, you know you can go to HebrewFoundation.org. You can click on the online donations, or you can click on PayPal. Either one, whatever the Father puts in your heart, you know, let the Father lead and guide you. So if you have any prayer requests, make sure you send them in. People email me, people text me, people Facebook me their prayer requests. So we always try to make sure we pray. And we thank Bina for singing our Olive Bet song. Kiki, you said you wanted to sing, didn't you? You want to sing the Olive Bet song with Bina?
You said you wanted to sing in the car on the drive home.
Okay, so we're gonna hold you over to next week. You'll be ready. 2 weeks. Okay, I'm gonna give you 2 weeks. The audience heard you. All right, Ms. Baka. Toda for all your patience, and again, please slicka us for being a little late. Excuse us. We just, you know, trying to get some things done. So, let's pray, Ms. Baka. Father, thank you for another Shabbat. I pray, Father, someone who's ever listening, that their soul was blessed. Let their spirit soar, Father. Let them be rooted and grounded in truth. Father, let this truth of the Torah penetrate our hearts, and then let it radiate out of us as a light. As the Mashiach said, ye are now the light of the world. Let your light so shine before men that they might see your good works and esteem your Father, which is in Shamaim of heaven. Thank you, Father. Let our good works show forth, because we know that faith without works is dead. Thank you, Father, for perfecting this in us. Thank you for letting our faith and our works come together, that will produce life and life more abundantly. In the name of Mashiach, Yahusha, Hallel to Yahuwah. Amen.
Amen.
All right, ladies.
Remind Ms. Baka to your Ms. Baka.
Shabbat Shalom.